टाइप्स ऑफ कैपेसिटर ब्रॉडली कैपेसिटर आर क्लासिफाइड एज नॉन पोलराइज कैपेसिटर्स एंड पोलराइज कैपेसिटर्स. नॉन पोलराइज कैपेसिटर कंटेन्स फिल्म टाइप्स कैपेसिटर, मेटलाइज कैपेसिटर, पेपर कैपेसिटर, ओके एंड सीरामिक टाइप ऑफ कैपेसिटर्स. वेल पोलराइज कैपेसिटर्स हैव टू टाइप कैटेगरीज सुपर कैपेसिटर इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक कैपेसिटर. ओके यू मे हैव हर्ड अबाउट दिस इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक कैपेसिटर. इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक कैपेसिटर्स जनरली फॉर्म्ड ऑफ दिस एल्यूमिनियम कैपेसिटर्स, नियोबियम कैपेसिटर्स, टैंटलम कैपेसिटर्स. वेल सुपर कैपेसिटर्स आर हैविंग स्ट्रक्चरल डिफरेंसेस विच हैज डबल लेयर कैपेसिटर्स, स्यूडो कैपेसिटर्स, हाइब्रिड कैपेसिटर्स. Let us see some non-polarized and what is mean by this polarized and non-polarized capacitors. Okay, so this is the symbol of a non-polarized capacitor, and this is a symbol of polarized capacitor. So what does this mean? So one of the terminal in case of the polarized capacitor is connected to a positive terminal of a supply always. Okay, so yeah, why the non-polarized capacitor? Any terminal can be connected to any power supply. Okay, but in case of this polarized capacitor, this particular mentioned positive terminal has to be connected to positive power supply. If you don't do this, so the lifetime of a particular capacitor may reduce, and possibility that particular device or this capacitor may get damaged or burst out, right? So the equipment or the circuit will fail or may result in hazards. Okay? So this is the basic symbol difference between polarized and non-polarized capacitor. Okay. Let us see non-polarized capacitor, ceramic capacitors. Okay? So this is a pictorial of this disc type ceramic capacitor. What we see? There are two parallel plates, okay, and within that parallel plates there is a dielectric material, basically a ceramic material present between these two plates, and it is connected to two terminals. Okay. This thickness and the dielectric of this particular symmetric ceramic is going to determine these capacitors, right? Okay, so we have these two types, that is two classes, you can say, class one, class two, etc. Okay, so class one ceramic capacitor are having high stability and low losses for resonant circuit. So class 2 ceramic capacitor offers high volumetric efficiency for buffer, bypass and coupling application. So these are various disc type ceramic capacitor with markings as shown. Yeah. The materials that are used in this capacitor are zinc, zirconium, niobium, magnesium, tantalum, cobalt and strontium, etc. All those are used for designing or manufacture of those capacitors. Okay, let us see some specifications. Both class 1 and class 2, the operating voltage for class 1 is 6.3 volt to 3000 volt, while in case of class 2 we can see minimum voltage 4 volt to maximum voltage 3000 volt. Maximum temperature the capacitor can withstand is minus 55 degrees Celsius to one positive 125 degrees Celsius for both the classes. Capacitors, there is a various of these capacitors for both the classes. For class 1, 100 picofarad to 470 nanofarad range is available. In case of class 2 capacitor, 1 nanofarad to 1000 microfarad range of these capacitors is available. While the temperature coefficient for class 1 is plus minus 30 ppm per Kelvin, while in case of class 2, plus minus 15% per Kelvin. Okay. Film capacitors. So basically these are various films that are used within this capacitor by layer. Okay. So we see here one terminal and another terminal between this terminal. Okay. This is one terminal, this is another terminal within this layer. Layer, that is the layer dielectric layer is basically is of polymers or okay, high polymers. So there are various polymers or various films that can be used, like polypropylene, okay, polyester, polyethylene, tetrapolyethylene, okay, methylate, then polyphenyl sulfide, then polytetrafluoroethylene, polystyrene, then polycarbonate. Okay, so these are the various polyesters that can be used. So PET, PEN, PPF. Okay, so these are very commonly used type of dielectric. So these are some specifications. So yeah, these are the DC voltage range, operating DC voltage range for PET is 50 to 1000 volt, PEN is 16 to 250 volt, then PPS is about 16 to 100 volt, and PP, we can see it is operating under large range of voltage, 40 to 2000 volt. Capacitance for PET, it is from 100 picofarad to 22 microfarad, while PEN, that is 100 picofarad to 1 microfarad, PPS 100 picofarad to 0.47 microfarad, and for PP 100 picofarad to 10 microfarad. So what we can say that the range of a PET is larger as compared to other, and the minimum one which there is PPS. Okay, this PPS have offers very minimum you can say type of capacitors, right? So this can be used for lower signals, right? Yeah, this can be used for something moderate higher signals, right? So temperature range means this small signal, very small signal, high frequencies, right? And moderate frequency, intermediate frequency. Then temperature range this can be a PET can withstand from minus 55 degrees to 125 degrees Celsius, right? And PEN, same, minus 55 degrees Celsius to 150 degrees Celsius, okay. While PP, minus 55 to 105 degrees Celsius. Okay, so these were some basic important specifications on this film capacitors. Applications, as film capacitors are not polarized, they can be used in AC voltage application without AC bias, right? AC application, AC power supplies may be there. Okay, such applications, controllers, so AC power supplies, we can use these components. Oscillators and resonator circuits, electronic filter application with high quality factor gain, such as high pass filter, low pass filter, and band pass filter. Then tuning circuits, then for audio crossovers in loudspeakers. So these are some of the applications in capacitors. Next, paper capacitor. So this is what the structure of a particular paper capacitor, right? Yeah, these are the available paper capacitor in the market. Okay, so this is the different casing. So this is axial type. So what we see here is these are the axial type. What is happening here that we have the middle sheet, one end, well, this is one terminal, this is another terminal, right? And this within this what is there, this is the complete this is the complete sheet, and within the sheet we see that a layer of this particular paper, right? It is rolled or placed within this different separator. Okay, so paper can also be used as a dielectric medium. Okay, let us see the specification, right? So operating voltage is about 200 volt to 1600 volt. Yeah, so definitely this can be used at higher voltage, means higher power controlling applications. Okay, power line frequency. Maximum temperature that can be used to scan is 85 degree to 100 degrees Celsius. Capacitance is low, 0.01 to 20 microfarad. So that is why this can be used at power and power line means those incoming power to our homes or industries, right? That three phase or lines, what is the alternative power current? Yeah. So that at such application, this capacitor can be used. Temperature coefficient, what it says, plus minus 800 ppm per degree Celsius. Application paper capacitor is fixed capacitor in which flat thin strips of metal foil is separated by dielectric medium. Paper capacitor are used for medium capacitance value 1 nanofarad to 1 microfarad and mainly at power and frequency. Okay, mica capacitor. So these are the capacitor made using the mica as a dielectric material. parallel plates or parallel foils sandwich. Okay, so this is yeah, mica capacitor. Okay, so operating voltage is lies between the 50 volt to 100 kilowatts. So definitely these are going to use these are that this can be used for power applications, right? The assumed temperature it can withstand is minus 55 degrees Celsius to 150 degrees Celsius. Capacitance 2 picofarad to 470 microfarad. Okay. Temperature coefficient is plus minus 50 ppm per degree Celsius. Applications it can be used as filter, RF oscillator, coupling, anti-coupling, high frequency application with high Q. So, in designing communication systems, yeah, definitely during the RF transmissions, right? Definitely these capacitors are used. Okay.